In Jesus' name we pray.
Ni oruko Jesu ni agbadura.
Our Father, we thank you for the challenge you've given us.
Baba wa dupe lowo yin fun ipenija ti e fin fun wa.
That we as your children need to live by faith.
Pe awon omo yin gbodo ma gbe nipa igbagbo.
And that when we walk by faith and live by faith, there is no alarm we're going to feel, we're going to fear.
Pe ti a ba rin nipa igbagbo ti a ngbe nipa igbagbo ko si ohun kan ti o le si oke wa nidi a o bo wa labo yo.
We know that you are not a man that you will lie.
A mo pe yin ni Olorun e ki se eniyan to se ki.
Neither the son of man that will repent.
Be ni e ki so mi eniyan ti o fi ronuku wada.
You have blessed your children and nobody can reverse it.
E ti bukun fun awon omo yin na ko de si en to le yi egun si ori
won. You have pronounced good concerning us and nobody can turn it to evil. And we know that if we keep on looking at Jesus by faith, every other sin will bow to your word and your will in our lives in Jesus' name. We are praying, O Lord, that your word that enters into us tonight will strengthen our faith in Jesus' name. That it will drive away all our weaknesses. It will drive away all our fears. We pray, O Lord, you bring every one of us back into the path of faith in Jesus' name. Strengthen every one of your children. In Jesus' name we pray.
Ni oruko Jesu ni agbadura.
Last week we began the study of Hebrews chapter 11.
Ni ose ti o koja ni a bere si keko lati inu Hebrews ri kokanla.
And already we have seen verses 1, 2, and 3.
Ni bayi na ati keko ninu ese ikini si iketa.
We have already seen what faith is and what faith does.
Ati ri ohun ti igbagbo je ati ohun ti igbagbo ma nse.
Last week we learned of the definition of faith.
Ni ose ti o koja a ko nipa etumo igbagbo.
We saw the description of faith.
A ri apejuwe igbagbo.
We saw the declaration of faith.
Ati ri ikede ti akede nipa igbagbo.
Just to refresh your memory and for the benefit of those who are not here.
Lati ran yin leti ati fun anfani awon ti o si laarin wa ni ose ti o koja.
Verse 1, the definition of faith.
Ese akoko nso nipa itumo igbagbo.
Now faith is a substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen.
Nje igbagbo ni idaniloju ohun ti a n reti, ijeri ohun ti a ko ri.
It talks of something we are hoping for, we have not got it, it is still far away.
O so nipa nkan ti a n reti, ohun to wa ni ojo iwaju ti a o ti fowo wa ba.
The faith is the substance of that thing we're still hoping for.
Igbagbo ni ami tabi idaniloju ohun ti a n reti yen
gan. And then it says it is the evidence of things not seen.
O wa so pelu pe ohun gan ni ijeri ohun ti a ko ri.
Unbelievers do not have any evidence for what they cannot see.
Awon alaigbagbo won o ni ijeri fun ohun ti won ko ti ri.
But we as believers, the evidence, that is the substance, that is a reality, and that is a receipt that that thing that has been paid for already belongs to us, even though it is not parked in our garage. The receipt we are holding in our hand is the evidence that we have got it, it belongs to us.
Ìdániloju gẹ́gẹ́ bí ìwé tí a fi fún wa gẹ́gẹ́ bí ẹ̀rí bí a ò tí gba nǹkan náà sínú ibi tí a ń gbé ọkọ̀ sí. Ṣùgbọ́n ìgbàgbọ́ ni àmì pé a ti rí nǹkan náà gbà náà.
And then we are told that others that lived before us, they manifested that kind of faith.
A sì fi yé wa gbangba pé àwọn aṣáájú wa kan ti fi ìgbàgbọ́ yìí sójú àmì.
We are told of the patriarchs and the prophets and the people of the Old Testament.
A sọ fún wa nípa àwọn baba ńlá, àwọn wòlíì, àwọn ènìyàn nu májẹ̀mú láéláé.
In verse 2, for by it, that is by faith, the elders, referring to the people of the Old Testament, obtained a good report.
Ó sọ ní ẹsẹ̀ ìkejì pé nítorí nínú rẹ̀, ìyẹn ni pé nítorí nínú ìgbàgbọ́ ni àwọn alàgbà eléyìí tó tọ́ka sí àwọn baba ńlá nínú májẹ̀mú láéláé tí wọ́n ti ní ẹ̀rírẹ nípasẹ̀ ìgbàgbọ́.
That's a declaration of God approving men of faith.
Eléyìí ni ìkéde àwọn onígbàgbọ́ tí wọ́n ti kójú òṣùwọ̀n tí Ọlọ́run sọ nípa wọn.
And then we're told in verse 3.
A wá sọ fún wa ní ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹta.
The discernment by faith.
ìmòye nípa ìgbàgbọ́.
What we understand, what we have insight into by faith.
Ohun tí ó yé wa tàbí ohun tí a ń fi ojú inú wò nípa ìgbàgbọ́.
It says through faith we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God, so that the things which are seen were not made of things which do appear.
Ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹta nípa ìgbàgbọ́ ni a mọ̀ pé a ti dá ayé nípa ọ̀rọ̀ Ọlọ́run nítorí náà.
It talks of things in the future, things hoped for. It talks of things that are invisible, things not seen. It talks of the things in the past, the world, the universe, created by God. And then it tells us that it is by faith we draw in the things that is still future. It is by faith we believe the action of the past that God himself has done.
O so gbangba pe nipa igbagbo lo dabi gogo ti a fi nfa ohun ojo waju sumara eni ti a si ma nfi oju inu wo nti Olorun ti se koja nipa ise re nipa igbagbo.
And now that he has spoken about the description and the definition, the declaration, the discernment by faith, he now goes to another scene, which is a demonstration of faith.
Ni bayi niwon igba to ti so nipa itumo igbagbo kede nipa igbagbo tabi apejuwe nipa igbagbo ati imoye nipa igbagbo ni bayi o wa be so nipa igbagbo ti a bi soju se.
And he gives us some examples.
O wa fun wa ni awon apere kan.
He gives us the example of Abel.
O so nipa Abeli.
And the example of Enoch.
O so nipa Enoku.
And the example of Noah.
Bakan na lo so nipa Noah.
The people that believed in God.
Awon to je pe won gba Olorun gbo.
That's why today we're looking at the examples of living by faith.
Nitori na ni a se wo koko iwasu
the Lord is encouraging us through his word that we need to have faith, that he is have a firm persuasion of the things we are hoping for. We must have a firm confidence in God that he will do as he has
said.
He will do as he has said. In Isaiah chapter 55.
Ninu Isaiah ori karunde ni ogota.
Verses 10 and 11.
Ese ikewa ati ikokanla.
Reminding us, confirming within us that our God will do exactly as he has said.
Ora wa leti be lo nfese re mule ninu wa pe Olorun wa yi on to ba tenu re jade yo se.
For as the rain cometh down and the snow from heaven, and returneth not thither, but watereth the earth, and maketh it bring forth and bud, that it may give seed to the sower, and bread to the eater. So shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth. It shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish that which I please, and it shall prosper in the thing which I, wherein I send it.
Nitori gege bi oju ati oju didi ti orun wa ile. Tiki si to pada sohun sugba ti o rin le ti o si mu nkan hu jade ki o si rudi ki o si le fi iru fun awon afurugbin ati onje fun awon ojeun be ni oro mi ti o ti enu mi jade yo ri ki yo pada sodo mi lofo sugbon yo se yi ti o wu mi yo si ma serere ninu ohun ti mo ran.
He tells us that his word will not return unto him void.
O so fun wa gbangba pe oro ohun o ni pada sowo ohun sodo mi lofo.
If he has sent that word into your heart,
to ba ti ran oro na sinu okan re,
that word is going to accomplish the purpose and the plan of God in your life.
Oro yen yo mu ilepa Olorun ti o ran sinu aye re lati mu se.
It will not return back to heaven and say, Lord, I've gone to the man you sent me to, I've gone to the woman you sent me to, but I am powerless and I cannot do what you expected I should have done. There is nothing like that. Once the word has been sent unto us, it will accomplish everything, 100% of what God intended before it returns to him to go and give the report.
Oro na ko ni pada sodo Olorun ko wa ma jabo fun pe mo ti wonu aye okunrin tabi aye obirin to ran mi si sugbon ipa mi o kan tun fe nitori na oro na o le ri be lai lai gbogbo nti Olorun ba ni ko se ni yo se ni ase pe lai seku eyo kan nile yo se ase pe re.
In Jeremiah chapter 1 verse 12.
Jeremiah ori kini ese ikejila.
Then said the Lord unto me, thou hast well seen, for I will hasten my word to perform it.
Oluwa si fun mi pe iwo riran rere nitori ti emi o kiesi oro mi lati munse.
That is what gives the believer confidence.
Ele lo ma fokan nigbagbo bale.
That God will do as he has said.
Pe Olorun yo se gege bi o ba
ti so. It is this kind of faith.
Iru igbagbo yi gan.
That permits the believer to rejoice in firm assurance while waiting for the accomplishment of the promise given by God.
Iru igbagbo yi lo ma fun onigbagbo lati ni idaniloju to fese mule gbangban lori ohun ti o foju sona fun bi o tin reti re.
He knows it must come to pass.
O mo gbangba pe o n lati se ni.
He knows it will accomplish the purpose for which God sent it.
O mo pe n tolorun ni ko wa se yen yo se la se pe.
He knows the devil cannot destroy the power of the world.
O mo pe ipa esu ka lati se apa oro na.
He knows that God will not deny what he has said.
O mo pe olorun o ni ku oro re je n to ba ti so.
That is why by faith he now rejoices in firm assurance while waiting for the accomplishment of the promise, because he knows God is watching over his word to perform it.
Idini ya to fi je pe o ma nje ki iru eni be ko ma yo ninu idaniloju ti o duro gbangban gege bi o se nduro de mu se oro ti olorun ba so.
He knows that we're dealing with the God that calls the things which be not as though they were.
O mo pe olorun ta n ba lo ma n pe on ti o si gege bi eni pe o ti wa.
Because of that, he is fully persuaded that what he has promised is able also to perform.
Nitori na ni okan re se bale pe on ti olorun ba ti so pe on yo se o lagbara lati se.
And even though the unbelievers might not have seen the evidence of what God has done, he has grabbed it, he is holding on to it by faith, and is rejoicing with exceedingly great joy.
Bi o ti le je pe awon onigbagbo won o ni nkankan ti won le gbekele nipa ti Olorun so, ohun gege bi onigbagbo o ti fi okan igbagbo di mu be lo si yo pe ohun ti Olorun so yo se dandan.
He calls the things which be not as though they were just like God his Father.
O n pe ohun ti o si gege bi eni pe o ti wa.
In Romans chapter 4 verse 17.
Ninu Rome ori kerin ese iketadinlogun.
As it is written, I have made thee a father of many nations before him whom he believed, even God, who quickeneth the dead and calleth those things which be not as though they were.
Gege bi ati ko pe mo ti fi o si baba orilede pupo niwaju eni ti ohun gbagbo Olorun ti kara re ti o so oku di aye ti o si npe ohun ani ti ko si bi eni pe won ti wa.
Already your faith has understood.
Daju daju igbagbo re o ti ye na.
That God made everything you see now out of nothing.
Pe gbogbo n to foju ri bayi Olorun da ninu ohun ti o si.
Already you remember that he fed more than 3 million people for 40 years in the wilderness and gave them food without anything they could see.
O ti mo yi daju gbangba pe awon bi milionu meta eniyan ninu aginju fun ogoji odun gbako Olorun bo won pelu onje laisi pe won sun ogbe kankan
rara. Already you remember that he brought water out of the dry rock.
O ti ranti gbangba bayi wi pe lati nu apata to gbe Olorun mo mi jade ninu.
Already you remember he fed Elijah when there was famine in the land, and he didn't know, Elijah did not know where the bird was bringing the cake every day.
O ti mo gbangba wi pe Olorun yi kan na lo bo Elijah nigba ti iyan mu ni gbogbo ile ogbo ojojumo ni eye n gbe onje wa ba Elijah. Elijah mo bi to nje ti wa nigba ti Olorun
mo. Remembering all that, it becomes easy for you and for me to walk by faith.
Bi o se wa ranti awon nkan wonyi yo wa rorun fun iwo ati emi lati ma rin nipa igbagbo.
And to begin to call those things which be not as though they were.
Ati lati ma pe awon nkan ti ko si gege bi eni pe won ti wa.
Romans chapter 4 verse 21, being fully persuaded that what he had promised he was able also to perform.
Romo ri kerin ese ikokan le logun nigba ti o sa ti mo daju daju pe ohun ti o n ba ti leri o si le se.
This kind of faith pleases the Lord.
Iru igbagbo yi ma n ti Olorun lorun.
And now we're going to look at people that also manifested this kind of faith.
Ni bayi awon fe se ayewo awon eniyan ti won fi iru igbagbo yi soju ise.
We're looking at Abel.
Awon Abeli.
We're looking at Enoch.
Awon Enoku.
We're looking at Noah.
Bakan na la awon Noah.
These three people that the Lord brings before us.
Awon meta wonyi ti Olorun mu wa siwaju wa.
Took the first one from Genesis chapter 4.
O mu akoko ninu Genesis ori kerin.
He took the second one from Genesis chapter 5.
O mu ekeji ninu Genesis ori karun.
And he took the third one from Genesis chapter 6.
Eni keta o mu ninu Genesis ori kefa.
And then looking at all of them together,
bi a se wa nwo awon meteta papo,
he shows us through their lives,
o fi han wa nipa igbe aye won,
how to live by faith,
bi a se le gbegbe aye wa nipa igbagbo.
Abel, the first one,
Abel eni akoko,
tells us about the beginning of the life of faith.
O so fun wa nipa ibere igbe aye igbagbo.
Abel invites us, if we want to live by faith, he says says this is a starting point.
Ebeli o npe wa bayi pe ti a ba fe gbegbe aye igbagbo ibi ta ti bere ni.
Is the one that tells us about the commencement of the life of faith.
O lo so fun wa nipa ibere igbe aye igbagbo.
And then it was Enoch that tells us about the continuation and the continuity of the life of faith.
Enoku o lo wa so fun wa gbangba bi igbe aye igbagbo ibi ki se dawo duro ti o ma tesi waju ti o si ma tesi waju.
If Abel shows us the commencement, it was Enoch that tells us for 300 years, walking step after step and step by step, the continuity of the life of faith.
And
as Abel tells us the commencement, and Enoch tells us the continuity, it was a Noah that now shows us the consummation of the life of
faith.
As it was in the days of Noah, so shall it be at the coming of the Son of Man.
That
is very near to the end. We will need the kind of faith of Noah for the climax, for the consummation of the life we began with Abel, we continued with Enoch, so that we can end it up with the Lord. So in the verses we're looking at today, we're going to consider 3 points. Number 1, the commencement of the life of faith. Number 2, the characteristics of the life of faith. Number 3, the courage of the life of faith. We're now reading from Hebrews chapter 11 verse 4. By faith, Abel offered unto God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain, by which he obtained witness that he was righteous, God testifying of his gifts, and by it, he being dead, yet speaketh.
Nipa igbagbo ni Abeli ru ebo si Olorun ti o san ju ti Kaini lo. Nipa eyi ti a jeri re pe olododo ni. Olorun si jeri ebun re ati nipa re na bi o ti ku ni o nfo si be.
We find the story in Genesis.
A ri itan na ninu Genesis.
And I need to remind you, even though you know it already.
O si ye ki ran leti bi o ti le je pe o mo tele tele.
Adam and Eve had offended the Lord.
Nitori pe Adam ati Eve ati se Olorun.
And they were driven out of the presence of God.
A si ti le won kuro ni waju Olorun.
Which is the way to enter back into the presence of God.
Ele ti si ona, ewo ni ona na lati pada si waju Olorun.
That's what Abel is telling us.
Ohun ti Abel
Adam and Eve had gone into exile.
Adamu ati Eva won ti disan sabayi.
They have lost the dominion, they have lost the authority, they have lost the presence of the Lord from their lives.
Won ti padanu ijegaba, won ti padanu ase, won ti padanu iparahan Olorun ninu aye
won. They were outside the blessing.
Won wa lode ibukun Olorun.
Outside the garden.
Won wa nita
outside the joy and the peace of the kingdom.
Won o si laarin ayo ati ijoba Olorun mo.
Who will show us the way? The people that are born in exile, the people that are born outside the garden, the people that are born outside the kingdom, who will show us the way back into that garden, back into what we lost in Adam?
Awa to je pe ati di ajoji si ijoba Olorun ta leni na ti o wa ran wa lowo lati mo ona pada sinu ogba na.
That's what Abel is telling us.
Ohun ti Abel so fun wa ni.
You see, the land had been cursed.
Nitori pe ati fi le gego.
And man had been cursed.
Ati fi eniyan gego pelu.
And man is now outside the kingdom laboring under the heavy yoke of the curse.
Eniyan wa ni lode ijoba na to je pe o n jabutabuta ninu egun lati afile lori.
He is under condemnation.
O wa labe idaleji.
He is under judgment.
O wa labe idaleji.
sin did my mother conceive me?
Ninu ese ni mama mi
loyun mi. And in sin was I born?
Ninu ese, ninu ese dede
lati mi. Who can bring a clean sin out of an unclean? No, not one.
Ta lo le mu mi mo jade ninu aimo ko si enikan.
All we have gone away, we are fading away.
Gbogbo wa lati sina kakiri.
Our sins have separated us away from the Lord.
Ese wa ti ya wa ni pa kuro lodo Oluwa.
Who will show us back to the grace of God?
Ta wa ni yo ran wa lo lati mo ona pada sinu
ore Olorun. Bring us back into the favor of God. Who will bring us back into the presence of the Lord? Who will break the power of sin? How can we begin again? Which all our forefathers have lost? That's what Abel is teaching us. The beginning, the commencement of the life of faith. Look at it now in Genesis chapter 4. Reading from verse 1. And Adam knew Eve, his wife, and she conceived and bare Cain, and said, I've gotten a man from the Lord. But remember, he was born in exile. Outside the grace of God, outside the kingdom of God, outside the garden. In verse 2, and she again bare his brother Abel, and Abel was a keeper of sheep, and Cain was a tiller of the ground. And again, remember that Abel was born under the curse. He was born in exile. He was born outside the garden. He was born outside the favor of God. In verse 3, in the process of time, it came to pass that Cain brought of the fruit of the ground an offering unto the Lord. Now Cain brought something that had been under the curse. He himself was under the curse, separated from the Lord, out of the work of the hand of a cursed man. He brought the produce, developed produce from a cursed ground. And the cursed man, bringing the fruit of the accursed ground, brought it to God to appease God and get into favor with God. And no wonder he could not get into the kingdom. All our righteousnesses are like filthy rags. They are nothing before the Lord. But Abel did something. And that is the reason he entered into the record of God. And he did it by faith. And you know the Bible says that faith comes by hearing, hearing by the word of God. Abel had revelation. What kind of revelation did he have? Now you must understand, there are many ways to get the revelation of God, especially in those days. You will see that the Bible says all the creation of the world, they reveal God unto us. The heavens, they show the glory of God, and all his handiwork, they show who he is. God reveals himself sometimes by speaking to us directly, sometimes by his action.
Nigba miran Olorun ma nba wa soro ko soro tarata si wa tabi ko ba wa soro nipa ise re.
What action did Abel learn from?
Ninu ise wo ni Abel ti keko.
That brought revelation unto him.
Eleyi ti o mu ibihan to wa.
In Genesis chapter 3 verse 21.
Ninu Genesis ori keta ese ikokanlelogun.
Unto Adam also and to his wife did the Lord God make coats of skins and clothed them.
Ati fun Adam ati fun aya re ni Olu.
Can you see the revelation here? Can you see the action of the Lord here? Number one, Adam and Eve were naked. And their nakedness brought shame unto them. Number one, then all men are naked before the Lord, and they have shame and guilt and condemnation before the Lord.
Nitori na ohun akoko wa ni pe gbogbo mutumuwa gbogbo eniyan patapata ihoho gbalaja ni won wa ni waju olorun eleyi ti mu egan ati itiju ba won.
And so Abel realized
eleyi waye Abeli
that man had sinned
pe eniyan ti dese
and is naked and devoid of the glory of God.
O wa ni hoho be ni ogun olorun si lori re.
He is guilty and ashamed before the Lord.
Elebi ni eni itiju ni ni waju olorun.
Abel realized another thing.
Nitori na oye miran to waye Abeli.
And Eve had made something for themselves to cover themselves up.
Adam ati Eva awon fun ara won ti dogba kan tele lati bo.
But the covering was not effective. All that man can do for himself in his own religion cannot cover him up in the sight of the Lord. And then Abel realized that for Adam and Eve to be covered, they needed God himself to provide a covering for them. And for God to make the covering for them, an innocent animal must die.
Ki Olorun to wa le da bobo won eran ti o mo won mese and lati spa
be to take their place
lati gba ipo won.
Because the day that you eat of that thing you will die, and so he killed that animal as a substitute and then used the skin to cover their nakedness.
Nitori o ti so fun wa pe ojo ti e ba je ninu re eyin o ku nitori na o lati pa eran ko yi ki o wa mu awo re ko fi da bo won.
And so that provided a covering for them through the death of the innocent victim. The action of God concerning the covering of Adam and Eve revealed something to Abel. That revelation brought faith in his heart. He said, I know that my shame can be covered. And he brought the offering out to the Lord.
Oye waye Abeli na nigba na wi pe ki a to le bo mi a nla ti fi enikan ropo mi o wa mu ore wa fun Oluwa.
Genesis chapter 4 verse 4.
Genesis ori kerin ese.
And Abel also, he brought of the firstlings of the flock and of the fat thereof, and the Lord had respect unto Abel and to his offering.
Ati Abeli o pelu mu ninu akobi eran osin ati ninu awon ti o sanra Oluwa si fi oju rere wo Abeli ati ore re.
You see, that was the only way all sins could be forgiven. That was the only way that his sins could be atoned for. Because without the shedding of blood, his sins cannot be forgiven, his sins cannot be remitted, his sins cannot be atoned for. Don't you know what the Bible says in Leviticus chapter 17? Leviticus chapter 17 verse 11.
For
the life of the flesh is in the blood. I have given it to you upon the altar to make atonement for your souls. For it is the blood that makes an atonement for the soul. You see, an innocent victim had to die to take the place of Abel so that he can be counted righteous in the presence of the Lord.
Hebrews chapter 9
verse 22. It
is
telling us the same thing. And almost all things are by the law purged with blood, and without the shedding of blood is no remission. Jesus Christ, the innocent victim, the innocent sacrifice, he also came.
Yes, Oluwa, eni ti o je eni alailese ti ko si mo owo ko mese ohun na o wa wa.
When he appeared before John the Baptist,
nigba to farahan ninu oniwaju Johannu onitebomi,
John the Baptist pointed him out as a lamp of God that takes away the sins of the world.
Johannu onitebomi to ka si gege bi odo agutan Olorun to ku ese araye lo.
John chapter 1 verse 29.
Johannu ori kini ese ikokandinlogbon.
The next day John sees Jesus coming unto him and says, behold the Lamb of God which taketh away the sin of the world.
Ni jo keji Johannu ri Jesu nbo wa sodo re o si wi pe wo odu agutan olorun eni ti o ku ese aye lo.
Abel had the word through the action of God. He believed that word.
Abel gbo oro nipase ise olorun o si gba oro na gbo.
He acted upon that word.
O se igbe o gbe igbese nipa oro na.
He brought the innocent victim, the animal, to replace him, to be the substitute, to die the death he should have died.
O mu eranko na ti ko mo owo ti ko mese ti ko ni abawon lati dipo re ko di etutu fun lati dipo re.
And as the Lord saw that faith in him, that followed the same action that God had taken to cover the sin and the shame of Adam and Eve, the Lord approved of his faith. As you come to the Lord today, and you are not bringing the offering of
Cain,
you are not bringing the fruit of the ground, you are not bringing the work of your hand, you bring the Lord Jesus Christ, the perfect sacrifice. You hide behind the cross. You say, Jesus is my Savior. He is my substitute. The death I should have died, he died for me. He is the one that replaced
me.
All the punishment I should bear from in time and eternity, the Father Almighty God has laid the iniquity of us all upon him. And you count what he has done as an acceptable sacrifice for you. Like the Father accepted Abel and his offering, then he will accept you. In Hebrews chapter 11 verse
4,
by faith Abel offered unto God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain. A more excellent sacrifice. Because that of Cain was not acceptable, his own was acceptable. Because that of Cain did not have faith in it, it only had self-confidence and the sweat of man in it.
Nitori pe ti Kaini ko ni igbagbo ninu ogbon to wa nibe na ni ijore ni loju ati si owa
re. It is faith that makes what you do to be more excellent than what other people do.
O je mo pe igbagbo lo nje ki ohun ti o ba se ko lola tabi ko je itowo gbaju ta awon elomiran lo.
And then you say, by which you obtain witness that he was righteous.
O wa so pe nipa eyi ti a jeri re pe olododo ni.
By that he obtained witness that he was righteous. Righteousness there is not because of I do this, I don't do this, I don't drink, I go to church, I don't smoke, but because of accepting that perfect sacrifice, the substitute, you become righteous. The moment you accept Jesus Christ, that he is your Savior, you know he died for you. You have a deep, deep conviction within you that now your sins are forgiven because of what he has done. Then you become righteous in the sight of God. In Romans chapter 3, verse 24, being justified freely by his grace through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus. You are justified freely.
And
then we are told about
Abel,
by which he obtained witness. That's the same thing that happens to us according to Romans chapter 8. Romans chapter 8 verse 16. The Spirit itself beareth witness with our spirit that we are the children of God.
You
obtain witness and God testifying of his gifts, and he being dead yet speaketh.
Nipa
that although he is dead now, although he is gone now, he is still speaking. How is he speaking? His action is speaking to us.
He's
saying, if you want to begin the life of faith, don't depend upon yourself. Rely upon that innocent victim. Rely on that perfect sacrifice. Even though he is dead, he's still speaking to us. He said, if you want to come back to the garden, if you want to come back into the favor of God, if you want to enter into intimate relationship with the Lord, if you want the Lord to testify about you like he testified about me, rely on the perfect sacrifice that was made for you. Not on yourself, not on your good works, not on your religious activity. Just lean your whole weight upon the Lamb of God that takes away the sin of the world. He's still speaking to us today. And he tells us that is the beginning of the life of faith. And I pray that those who have not started this journey, they will begin it tonight in Jesus' name. But you see, the commencement is not the end. I told you there is commencement and there is continuity. Abel has shown us the commencement. It is now Enoch that tells us the continuity of the life of faith. And it gives us the characteristics of the life of faith while you are continuing to walk with the Lord. In Hebrews chapter 11, reading from verse 5, by faith Enoch was translated that he should not see death, and was not found because God had translated him. For before his translation, he had this testimony that he pleased God. I want you to understand and underline those words. He pleased God. Having said that, you will want to please the Lord. And you say, I want to do everything I can to please the Lord. Because of that desire in your heart, immediately he tells us in verse 6 how to please the Lord. He says, you want to please the Lord? You want to make the Lord happy? You want him to look at your life and be well pleased with you? He said, how are you trying to do it? Then he tells us in verse 6, but without faith, it is impossible to please
him.
How many religious things some people try to do, thinking, if I do this and do this, I will please the Lord. And they don't think about faith. And yet without faith, it is impossible to please him. Our lives will not please the Lord without faith. Our service will not please the Lord without faith. Our prayer will not please the Lord without faith. Even our fasting will not please the Lord without faith. We may give our body to be burnt, and all that will not please the Lord without faith. Religion by itself, whatever those religions are doing, will not please the Lord without
faith.
But without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God must believe. It starts like that, it continues like that, it ends like that. He must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder.
ati pe oni olusesan
of them that diligently seek him.
Fun awon ti o fi ara balẹ wa.
Let us look at this example that the scripture is giving us, the example of Enoch.
E je ki a wo apere yi, apere ti iwe mimo fin fun wa nipa ti Enoch.
The Bible records about his life in Genesis chapter 5.
Bibeli se akosile nipa igbe aye re nu Genesis ori karun.
And tells us in verse 22, verse 23 and verse 24.
O so fun wa ni ese ikejilelogun iketalelogun ati ikerinlelogun.
This man that pleased the Lord.
Eni ti Olorun kan sara ti.
By faith he pleased the Lord. How did he please the Lord by faith? What did the faith produce that pleased the Lord?
Pe nipa igbagbo lo se wo Olorun. Bawo lo se wo Olorun? Kini nkan to se ti inu Olorun fi dun si?
In verse 21, and Enoch lived 65 years and he begat Methuselah.
Ese ikokan le logun Enoch si wa ni 60 odun o le marun o si bi Methuselah.
And Enoch walked with God after he begat Methuselah 300 years and begat sons and daughters.
Enoch si ba Olorun rin ni odun odun leyin ti o ti bi Methuselah o si bi omokunrin ati omobirin.
And all the days of Enoch were 365 years.
Gbogbo ojo Enoch si je 40 odun o din marundinlogoji.
And Enoch walked with God and he was not, for God took him.
Enoch si ba Olorun rin on ko si si nitori ti Olorun mu lo.
To start with, we need to understand that this was a true story.
Lati bere na o ye ki eyi ko ye wa wi pe itan to to ni eleyi.
How do we know it's a true story?
Ba lo se mo pe itan to to ni.
Because Abel was a true person, an historical person that actually existed.
Nitori pe ni ti Abeli eniyan bi ti wa ni eniyan to to ni ti a si ko itan nipa
re. And even Jesus mentioned the name of Abel.
Jesus fun ara re menu ba oro Abeli.
When he spoke of the blood of Abel and the blood of Zacharias, who was killed in persecution and was talking to the Pharisees, he was an historical figure.
Nigba to so nipa eje Abeli ati Zacharias eni ti a pa nitori inu ni bi ni eleyi fi mu wa da wa loju gbangba pe awon to ti wa laye ni
won. And so Enoch was a real person.
Nitori na Enoch na eniyan bi ti wa ni.
And Jude mentions his name.
Judah o ti e menu ba ruko
re. And even tells us the position after Adam and Cain and Seth and all the others. It says Enoch the seventh from Adam.
O ti e so ipo ti re gan leyin igba to so nipa Adamu Abeli ati awon elomiran o ni Enoch eni keje ninu Adamu.
He even told the name of one of his children, a firstborn,
Methuselah.
Now we are told that by faith he pleased the Lord. What was the singular thing, the important thing, the central thing that pleased the Lord in the life of Enoch? Verse 22, and Enoch walked with God. Verse 24, and Enoch walked with God. You see, his walk with God was the walk of faith. And the Bible asks us the question, can two walk together except they be agreed? He was in agreement with God. And he himself had started the way Abel started. And because he was 65 years of age, before he began to walk by faith. For 65 years, he was walking by unbelief. He was walking by sight. He was walking according to the course of the world. He was walking in the vanity of the minds of the Gentiles. He was living like everybody around. At a particular age, at a particular point, at 65 years of age, he decided, I'm going to walk by faith. Here is the beginning of the life of faith.
Sugbon nigba ti o pe ojo kan ninu aye re nigba ti o pe 60 odun o le marun o wa se ipin ninu okan re pe ohun yo ma gbe igbaye igbagbo.
Isn't that the same thing with you?
Se bo ti bora na ti ri fun
o. You were living in unbelief before.
O n gbe ninu igbagbo tele.
Walking according to the vanity of the minds of the Gentiles.
O rin gege bi asatin be ni okan won se.
Walking according to the course of this world.
O rin gege bi agbara tin sise ninu aye yi.
But then at a particular time you took a decision.
Sugbon lojo kan o wa yan ipinu.
I'm going to stop.
Pe n o da duro bayi.
I'm going to start afresh.
N o bere lotun.
I'm going to begin a walk of faith.
Ma bere irin igbagbo.
And you believe believed on the Lord Jesus Christ.
O wa gba Jesu Oluwagbo.
And then you begin the walk of faith right now.
Lati igba na wa ririn igbagbo.
When we talk of the walk of faith, what does it mean?
Nigba ti a ba so pe ka ma rin nipa igbagbo, kini
o tumo si? Number one, it means walking in the newness of life.
Akoko ni pe ki a ma rin ninu igbe aye otun.
In Romans chapter 6.
Ninu Romu ori kefa.
Reading from verse 4.
A o ka lati ese ikerin.
Romans chapter 6, reading from verse 4.
Romu ori kefa lati ese ikerin.
The significance and the meaning, the implication of starting to walk by faith.
Ohun to tumo si ani to tumo si gan lati ma rin nipa igbagbo.
Therefore we are buried with him by baptism into death, that like as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, even so we also should walk in newness of life.
Nje a fi baptismo sinu iku sin wa po pelu re pe gege bi ati ji Kristi dide kuro ninu oku nipa ogo baba be ni ki awa pelu ki o ma rin ni otun iwa.
You see, the beginning, the old life is dead.
Ori ibere ni pe igbe aye atijo ti ku dalu.
The old life is buried with him in baptism.
Igbe aye atijo ati sin pelu re ninu baptism.
And then we're raised up in newness of life.
Ati wa ji wa dide ni otun iwa.
If any man be in Christ, a new creature.
Bi eni keni ba nbe ninu Kristo
je dadu. All things have passed away.
Ohun atijo ti koja lo.
All things have become new.
Kiyesi ohun gbogbo di otun.
And now we begin to walk in the newness of life. That means then there is a change. The old is gone and the new has begun. In Ephesians chapter 4 verse 17. Ephesians chapter 4 verse 17. It says this, I say therefore. In verse 17. It says this, I say therefore, and testifying the Lord, that ye henceforth walk not as all the Gentiles walk in the vanity of their mind.
Ǹjẹ́ èyí ni mo ń wí tí mo sì ń jẹ́rìí nínú Olúwa pé láti ìsinsìnyí lọ kí ẹ̀yin kí ó má se rìn mọ́ àní gẹ́gẹ́ bí àwọn kèfèrí ti máa ń rìn nínú ìró asán wọn.
That means number two now, it means you are walking uprightly and righteously and honestly and walking humbly with thy God.
Ìyẹn ni ìkejì pé o wá ń rìn dédé, o ń rìn ní òdodo, o ń rìn ní ẹ̀tọ́, o ń rìn ní ìwà mímọ́ pẹ̀lú Ọlọ́run rẹ.
It means that you are no more defiled with the dirty things of the world, you now walk according to the law of God.
Ìyẹn ni pé àwọn ìríra ayé o kò máa ṣe àkóso ayé rẹ mọ́, o wá ń rìn gẹ́gẹ́ bí àwọn òfin Ọlọ́run.
It means you are walking in the ways that the Lord himself has commanded.
Ìyẹn ni pé ní báyìí ọ̀nà tí Ọlọ́run là sílẹ̀ ni o wá ń tọ̀.
It means you are now walking in the truth, you are walking in the light, you are walking in the spirit, and you are no more fulfilling the lust of the flesh.
Ìyẹn ni pé nísinsìnyí ò ń rìn nínú òtítọ́, ò ń rìn nínú ìmọ́lẹ̀, àwọn ìwà tara o kò mú wọn ṣe mọ́.
As we talk about walking with the Lord,
bí a ṣe ń sọ nípa bíbá Ọlọ́run
rìn, we have seen the case of Enoch.
A ti rí nípa ti Enoch.
But maybe the case of Enoch will not help many people.
Bọ́yá ọ̀rọ̀ ti Enoch kò ràn ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ lọ́wọ́.
He lived for 300 years.
Nítorí pé ọdún ọdún ló fi wà láàyè.
And he walked with God.
Ó sì bá Ọlọ́run rìn.
And yet we have only 3 verses telling us about it.
Tí a sì ní ẹsẹ̀ mẹ́ta péré tó ń sọ nípa ọ̀rọ̀ ayé rẹ̀.
That he walked with God, he walked with God, he walked with God.
Pé ọkùnrin ìbá Ọlọ́run rìn, ó bá Ọlọ́run rìn, ó bá Ọlọ́run rìn.
But the details are not given.
Ṣùgbọ́n àsọyé ìpa ayé rẹ̀ làwọn sọ.
But thank God we have the detail of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Ṣùgbọ́n pẹ́ ni fún Ọlọ́run pé a ní àkọsílẹ̀ nípa ayé
Jésù. He was 33 and a half years he walked with God here on earth.
Ọdún mẹ́tàlélọ́gbọ̀n àti àbọ̀ ló fi rìn nínú ayé yìí.
He overcame temptation.
Ó borí ìdánwò.
He overcame the devil.
Ó borí èsù.
He was undefiled.
A kò bàjẹ́.
He was holy.
Ó jẹ́ mímọ́.
He was pure.
Ó jẹ́ ẹni mímọ́.
He lived separate from sinners.
Ó yapa kúrò láàrin àwọn ẹlẹ́sẹ̀.
He challenged all the people, which of you convinced me of sin.
Ó pe gbogbo àwọn ènìyàn níjà pé ta lórí ẹ̀sùn ohunkóhun fi kàn mí.
He gives us the details of walking in a way that will please the Lord, because the Father said, "There is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased."
Ó ló sọ àsọyé pé tó péye nípa bí a ṣe ń bọ́ Ọlọ́run rìn, nítorí pé Ọlọ́run ga fọwọ́ sọ̀yà nípa ìgbé ayé rẹ̀ pé yíyí ni àyànfi ọmọ mi ẹni tí inú mi dùn sí gidigidi.
And in 1 John chapter 2 verse 6.
Nínú Jòhánù kìíní orí kejì ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹfà.
1 John chapter 2 verse 6.
Jòhánù kìíní orí kejì ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹfà.
He that says he abideth in him ought himself also so to walk, even as he walked.
Ẹni tí ó bá wí pé òun gbé inú rẹ̀, òun náà pẹ̀lú sì yẹ láti máa rìn gẹ́gẹ́ bí òun ti rìn.
And we walk continuously, continually, constantly, walking with the Lord.
A sì máa rìn ìrìn náà sísẹ̀ntẹ̀lé léraléra ní gbogbo ìgbà pẹ̀lú Olúwa.
In Hebrews chapter 11 verse 5.
Nínú Hebrews orí kọkànlá ẹsẹ̀ ìkarùn-ún.
Look at verse 5.
Ìwọ́ wo ẹsẹ̀ ìkarùn-ún.
By faith Enoch was translated that he should not see death, and was not found because God translated him, for before his translation, he had this testimony that he pleased God.
Nipa igbagbo li a si noku ni po pada ki o ma se ri iku a ko si ri nitori ti Olorun si ni po pada nitori si waju isipo pada re a je ri yi si pe owo Olorun.
And do you notice one word that is coming up and coming up and coming up again, and in that single verse that word is mentioned 3 times?
O wa ri awon oro to nje jade lera lera ninu ese kan soso ye meta lo farahan.
Look at it. Enoch was, this is the word, translated.
Oro na ni o Enoku asinipo pada.
And then look at it again. God had translated him.
Tunwo lekan si Olorun si nipo pada.
And look at it again, for before his translation.
Iwo tunwo lekan si nitori saju isipo pada re.
His life is telling us something.
Igbe aye re wa so nkan kan fun wa.
It's telling us what the church is waiting for.
O so nipa ti ijo nro
de fun wa. The translation, the rapture that will take place.
Isipo pada, iyipo pada ti o sele.
His experience tells us the meaning and the significance of that translation.
Igbe aye re o so fun wa itumo isipo pada yi
gan. The meaning of that translation is that he should not see death.
Itumo isipo pada yen gan ni pe ki ohun ki o ma se ri iku.
The meaning of it is that he will not be found on earth, neither living on earth, neither buried in the cemetery.
Ah, o to ti mo si pe asi ni po pada ni pe a o ni ri ninu aye ki a wa lo sin mo sare nibi ti a nku awon oku si.
And then we're told in Genesis that God took him away.
A ti so fun wa ninu Genesis pe Olorun fun rara re lo mu lo.
To be with him and to live with him.
Lati lo wa pelu re ko ma gbe pelu re.
You understand then the meaning of rapture and the meaning of that translation.
Oye isipo pada ati igbasoke wa ti yo bayi.
God taking you.
Olorun amu o.
Not allowing you to see death.
O ma se je ko ri iku.
Taking you to be with himself.
O mu e lo sodo ara re.
And then that you are no more found in the world and you are not found in the cemetery.
Ki a ma ri o ninu aye mo be ni laarin sare a ko ni ri o nibe.
And then we are told of the people that will be translated.
A ti so fun wa nipa awon ta o si nipo pada.
They will be the people that are pleasing God.
Awon na ni eni ti o te Olorun lorun.
They will be the people that have faith in God and by that faith they are pleasing him.
Awon ni eni ti o ni igbagbo ninu Olorun to je pe nipa igbagbo yi won wu Olorun.
They will be the people that are walking with the Lord in agreement with God in everything.
Awon to nba Olorun rin ni sowo po pelu Olorun ninu ohun gbogbo.
The Bible tells us that translation time is coming.
Bibeli so fun wa pe akoko esipo pada yi nbo.
In 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verse 51.
Ninu Korinti kini ori kedogun ese ikokanlelaadada.
Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed.
Ki esi ohun ijinle ni mo so fun yin gbogbo wa ki yo sun sugbon gbogbo wa la pa larada.
In a moment, in a twinkling of an eye, in the last trump, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead in Christ shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed.
Lọ́gán ní ìṣẹ́jú ní ìgbà ìpè kẹyìn nítorí pé ìpè yóò dùn. A o si je awon oku dide lai dibaje, a o si pa wa larada.
That's what the church is waiting for.
Ohun ti ijo nduro de niyan o.
And thank God you will take part in it.
Ope ni fun Olorun pe wa wa ninu won.
Because you are walking by faith.
Nitori pe o rin nipa igbagbo.
Because you are following the Lord by faith.
Nitori pe o tele Oluwa nipa igbagbo.
As he took Enoch away, he will take you away.
Bi o se mu Enoch lo be ni yo mu o lo.
In 1 Thessalonians chapter 4.
Ninu Thessalonica kini ori kerin.
Verse 16 and verse 17.
Ese ikerindinlogun ati iketadinlogun.
For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise forth. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up, translated, caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. We will ever be with the Lord.
Nitori Oluwa ti kara re yo sokale lati orun wa ti on ti ariwo pelu ohun olori awon angeli ati pelu ipe Olorun awon oku ninu Kristi ni yo si kojinde nigba na le a si gba awa ti o wa laaye ti o ku leyin soke pelu won sinu awon samo lati pade Oluwa le oju orun be le awon si ma wa titi lai lodo Oluwa a wa lodo Oluwa.
We have seen the commencement of the life of faith.
Ati ri ibere igbe aye igbagbo.
We have seen the continuation, the continuity, the characteristic of the life of faith, talking about Enoch.
Ati ri itesiwaju nisisentele iwa igbe aye igbagbo to so fun wa nipa igbe aye Enoch nipa biba Olorun rin.
But then Noah comes up.
Ni bayi o Noah wa je jade.
And he says you need to see the consummation of the life of faith.
O wa ni o lati ri ase pe tabi
Because he's telling us something. That as we're talking about the rapture, there is a part of that rapture that is similar to what happened to Enoch. But you see, there is a lot relating with the life of Noah. First of all, you know, in the case of Noah, the Lord told him there will be a flood that will cover the whole earth. You know, the Lord is telling the church there is going to be a great tribulation that is going to cover the whole world. In the case of Noah, nobody had seen any rain or flood like that before that time. In the case of the church, the tribulation that is going to come after the church has been taken away, it had never been so like that. No, it shall never be. In the case of Noah, he was preaching to them, he was a preacher of righteousness, but all the people around did not believe. In the case of the church, is the people that are righteous and holy, that the Lord will select and take to be with himself, and the unrighteous and the sinners will be left behind to go through the flood of the tribulation of God. In Matthew chapter 24, the Lord tells us the similarity between the time of Noah and the time of the church.
Matthew 24:37.
But as the days of Noah were, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. For as in the days that were before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, until the day that Noah entered into the ark. And they knew not until the flood came and took them all away, so shall it be at the coming of the Son of Man. In Hebrews chapter 11 verse
7,
by faith Noah being warned of God of things not seen as yet. Remember, of things not seen as yet. Do you remember the definition of faith? Faith is the substance of the things so far, the evidence of things not seen. Of things not seen as yet.
Igbagbo ni daniloju ohun ti a nreti, ijeri ohun ti a ko ri, ohun ti a ko ti foju gani.
You see, when God warned Noah of the flood coming, nobody had seen rain, nobody had seen flood before that time. It was something that had never been seen, and yet he believed, because faith is the evidence of things not seen.
Ora ti pe nigba ti Olorun kilo fun Noah wi pe ojo nbo ifun omi yo de.
Is that same faith that we have today? We have not seen heaven. Things not seen as yet, but we know there is heaven. That's faith. When the Bible warns us of evil habits of sin because of hell, we have not seen hell, and yet we know it has been announced to us, it has been read in the Word of God. Things not seen as yet we believe.
Nigba ti Olorun kilo fun wa to ke gbanjare nipa awon iwa bi ele to le mu eniyan lo si orun apade a o ti ri orun apade loju koroju sugba agbagbo pe orun apade nbe igbagbo ni daniloju on ti a ko ti ri.
There shall be great tribulation in that day such as has never been in the world before. We have not seen it, yet we believe. That's faith.
Ipanju nla yo wa ninu aye iru eti o ti si lati igba ti aye ti se a o ti ri ipanju nla isoju sugba agbagbo ele ni igbagbo.
And when God warns us of the judgment to come, and we tremble at his word, and we believe that what he has said he will do. He will punish the unbeliever, he will punish the unrighteous, and we act in faith and we repent. We believe of that judgment to come, even though we have not seen it. That's the faith of Noah.
Gbogbo elese to ba n wa run ki ti won ti an fari gapa won ni tuba gbogbo won pata ni olorun yo je ninja awa o ti ri sugba gbagbo pe on to olorun ba ma so yo ma se elei ni ri igbagbo noa.
By faith Noah, being warned of God of things not seen as yet, moved with fear.
Nipa igbagbo ni Noah nigbati olorun kilo ohun ti a ko ti ri fun o beru.
Can you see the connection between faith and fear?
O ti ri n to se asepo igbagbo ati iberu
bayi. God said I'm going to judge the world.
Olorun ni won se daju aye.
It's going to be terrible.
Pe yo le lopolopo.
All the unbelievers will die.
Gbogbo alaigbagbo yo ku.
The Lord will sweep them away.
Ikun omi yo gba won danu.
He knew that God is powerful, he can do it.
O mo pe alagbara olorun o si le se.
God is a serious personality. If he says he will do it, he will do it.
Olorun o mo n to se to ba so pe won o se nkan yo se.
It's a fear thing to fall to the hands of the living God. He feared to wait for the judgment of God. Because of that fear, he acted and did what God told him to do. That is faith. He prepared an act to the saving of his house. It took him years. While he was building it, there were people making fun of him. Uncle Noah has gone out of his senses. He's talking of rain and flood. He's talking of what science does not know anything about. Something that has never happened, that will never happen. He refuses to enjoy life. When others are eating and drinking and marrying and giving in marriage, look at him. He stays with one wife and all his sons staying with one wife. Each look at him is punishing himself.
Gbogbo eyan je won mo won fe yawo won fe aya ohun fun ara re yawo kan lo ni o to fe aya kan kan fa won mo re inu e si dun pelu aya kan je ko ma ba lo.
He will not enjoy life now. He's afraid judgment is coming. Judgment is coming.
Koni gbadun aye nisisin eru kan ba ke idajo nbo idajo nbo.
His faith had courage.
Igbagbo re o ni igboya.
The courage to stand alone.
Imolokanle lati
gboro nkan. The courage to believe the Lord.
Imolokanle lati gba ru
agbo. All the other people were on the other side. He stood firm in the courage of the life of faith.
Yo ti le je pe gbogbo awon eyan yoku patapata ni won duro legbe kan o nikan da duro lori igbagbo re lai
yese. He didn't mind the ridicule.
Ko bikita nipa efe ti won se.
The jesting. All the things they were saying.
Ati gbogbo oro alibasa
ti won sọ. And then were told he build there for the saving of his house.
A si so fun wa pe o si
by which he condemned the world. His faith condemned the unbelief of the world. His conviction condemned the carelessness of the world. And he became the heir of righteousness, which is by faith. As we know that the world is coming to an end. Do you believe that? That's the courage of faith. Because all your neighbors don't believe that. They don't believe that the world will come to an end. They think we're unreasonable. They feel that cannot be true. But thank God we have courage in our faith.